true worship is God-centered worship. It's not all about ourselves, but it's all about God. Going to church is not all about our friends. It's not all about our sweethearts. It's not all about our crush. But it's all about God. Our minds must be focused on God's only. And we must always prepare our hearts and minds to meet our God. And worshiping God is worshiping Him in spirit and in truth.
Aside from all this, the story of Moses when he met God in the mountain, what constitutes true worship is that the presence of God is in the place and also it is founded in spirit and in truth, and it is flowing from the heart, and also the minds and the will of men are subjected to God's own will. That's all.
The thing that constitutes the true worship is the presence of worshipers whose heart is really earnest, having the earnest desire to praise and glorify God and bring back all the glory and thanks to Him, and also the presence of God in the worship. That's for me what constitutes true worship.
What constitutes true worship? It's the motive. The motive is very important in worshiping God, because we might look good in PIC or other churches. We might dress well, we have very good clothes or very good appearance, but our motive is not correct. We have a problem in worship. In Romans 12:1, we are told by Paul that I beseech you therefore, brethren, that you present your body a holy sacrifice, acceptable, for this is our reasonable service. We should give our best, because what we are worshiping is the true God, the mightiest God, and the God of the universe. That's why when we worship Him, we should be pure in our hearts. We should have the holiness, and our motive is correct.
Worship in the dictionary is similar to profound love and admiration. Love, another similarity is love, devotion, adoration, reverence, adoration, fear. And one example of worship, true worship in the Bible, is the difference between Cain and Abel's worship. Abel worshiped God in a prescribed way, but Cain worshiped God in his own way. So the results will tell you which is accepted and which is not. Another way to worship God is to obey. The Bible says, if you love me, keep my commandments. And also studying God's word. Of course, when you study God's word, you try to see what is God's will, how God wants us to worship. And the number one thing I want to show is that reverence. Reverence in clothes, reverence in associations, social relationships, reverence in music, reverence in how, in our life, how we live our life, in what we watch in TV. Our whole life is what shows who we worship. That's it. Thank you.